Hello everyone. So in the last period we had seen introduction or beginning part of Dick Whittington and his cat. Dick Whittington. Yes, where did he live? In a small village of South England. And in a cottage he used to live, and once he heard that there was gold on the road of London, so he thought to go to London to take that gold and to become rich. But what happened? He went to London. Did he get gold? No. He did not get any gold. So he was disappointed. He was very sad. And he was very hungry also. Next day when he got up from the sleep. Where was he sleeping? In the alley. Means just behind the buildings. In a small passage of that those buildings he was sleeping. And before that day he did not eat anything. Simply he walked and walked in search of that gold. And what happened? He was asking for food. But what were the people saying? Hey lazy fellow, don't you feel shame for asking food? He was very sad. Then what happened next? Today we shall see here. By chance, Dick had fallen in front of a house belonging to a rich merchant called Mr. Fitzwarren. What was the name? Fitzwarren. The cook was trying to drive Dick away. Then Mr. Fitzwarren returned home from inspecting his sheep. He stopped and said to Dick, "Why don't you work if you need food?" Now, Fitzwarren, he was a rich person, and he came from the sheep after his business. And when he saw that his cook was driving away Dick from that place, he asked, who asked? Fitzwarren. To whom? To Dick. Why don't you work? You need food, na? Then why don't you work? Work and get food. Then I would work, said Dick, but I know nobody who will give me anything to do. I will work, but nobody who will give me work? Dick asked. I am ready to work, but who will give me work? Take him into the kitchen. Mr. Fitzwarren ordered the cook. He ordered his cook. Take him to the kitchen. Feed him first and then find some work for him. Give him for eating, then give him some work. Who said? Fitzwarren said to that cook. So Dick was given a home and a living. He had a small corner of the attic to sleep in, and his job was to help the cook with all the pots and pans in the kitchens. Now see, he was given place to live, he was given food, he was given a corner to live, and he was given work also. Yes, what kind of work he had to do? He had to help cook. Yes, he had to help cook. And which place did he get? He got attic. Attic means a very small room. A very small room where just near the roof or ceiling. Yes, a very small room. He got placed there to live, to sleep. Then Dick's life should have been much better than before, but he still had two difficulties to face. Now he had two difficulties. His life was better, but now he had to face two difficulties. What was his work? To help cook in the kitchen. Now let us see what was the difficulty. The first was that attic he slept in was overrun by rats and mice. Where he was sleeping in that attic, What were there? Rats and many mice. Mice, it is plural of mouse. There were rats and mice. So now you just think, if rats and mice are there in your room, can you sleep properly? No, you can't sleep properly. Here also, Dick had this first problem or first difficulty, that he had to sleep in the company of rats and mice. At night, this scampered all over him and kept him away whole night. They were scampering, they were hopping, jumping on his body by making sounds. So he could not sleep. He was just living awake at night. How can he sleep? After a time, he solved this problem by saving the few pennies he was paid and buying himself a cat. What did he do? He got money for his work. And with that, he saved some penny. Penny means money. He saved some money, and with that money, he bought new cat. Why did he buy that new cat? For those rats and mice. Yes, Missy got solution for that problem. What was the problem? Rats and mice were scampering or jumping in his room. That's why he could not sleep properly. So he, with his saved money, he bought a cat, and his problem was solved. In one time at all, the cat chased away all the rats and mice, and Dick was able to sleep peacefully. That's why he was sleeping peacefully now. He had no problem for sleeping. The other difficulty, our second difficulty, first difficulty solved, our second difficulty, which was not easy to overcome, and that difficulty was not easy to solve. To overcome means to solve, to succeed, to become successful in solving the problem. Overcome means what? To become successful in solving the problem. Was the cook's bad temper means he was short temper means was getting angry very soon for any silly reason, for small things that cook was becoming angry. He shouted and screamed all day and would scold Dick and hit him with a wooden spoon even when he was working as hard as he could. Dick was working so hard. Yes, but he was getting scoldings, hittings from that cook. He was treated so badly by that cook even though he was working so hard. This was the second difficulty. What was the second difficulty? Bad temper of the cook he had to face. Yes, this was the second difficulty. One night, Dick decided he could stand it no more. Now he decided to leave that place. Yes, he thought, I cannot tolerate hitting and beatings and scoldings of this cook. So he decided to leave. Early the next morning, before the cook was up, he set out with his cat to seek his fortune elsewhere. Before cook get up early in the morning, what did he do with his cat? He set up from that place to see his new luck to other place. Yes, because already he was tired of the cook's treatment. So that's why he decided to leave that place and to find work to other place with the cat. The two of them walked as far as Holloway near the place. On their way out of London, then Dick sat down on the stone to rest. Who were walking? Cat and Dick. They were walking. At last, Dick sat on one stone for rest. Then it was the 1st November, All Saints Day, and church bells were ringing. What were ringing? Church bells were ringing. As Dick sat and listened, it seemed they were ringing out a message for him. As the bells were ringing and he was thinking, a message is there in the ringing. What was the message? Turn again, Whittington, thou worthy citizen, Lord Mayor of London. Yes? Turn again, Whittington, thou worthy citizen, Lord Mayor of London. Lord Mayor of London? Said Dick. I should like to be a Lord Mayor and ride in a fine coach. Lord Mayor of London? Lord Mayor of London means it is just like a feeling of king. Mayor is just like a king of that London. Not king exactly, but he could see everything in that London. He will become what? One kind of mayor of that London. Great dream it was. It was a great dream. And ride in a fine coach, you know, coach, a vehicle, fine coach, a royal vehicle in which only mayor can ride or sit. I can put up with a QR code from the cook if that is what is in store for me. If I tolerate or bear scoldings of cook for more days, then definitely after some days, with my luck and with my hard work, what will happen? I will become mayor of this London. What will I become? Mayor of this London. So Dick and his cat retraced their steps to Mr. Fitzwarren's house. Luckily, they were able to sleep back before they had been missed. So Dick decided to come back to Fitzwarren's house. And luckily, fortunately, nobody saw them that while going out also and while coming in also. Now Mr. Fitzwarren used to send ships far across the sea to trade with other countries. Yes, what was the business of Mr. Fitzwarren? To send ships to other countries. For what purpose? For doing business. Trade. Trade means for doing business. He would load a ship with goods for the captain and ship's crew to sell in a far places, and then they would bring back goods that could be sold at home. Then what did he do? Goods means mal. Goods means mal or products. He was loading in the ship, and ship's crew means the people who are working on the ship, that called crew. For selling that products or that goods to different countries. Yes, and lot of goods they could have sold. So up to here we studied rest of the part. Next part we shall study in the next period. Okay, with this I stop here, but you have to complete the homework of hard words and send me on WhatsApp. Till then, bye bye.